getting to a cure is going to be difficult, no two ways around it. However, in the 32 years I've been a neurosurgeon, the immune therapy is the first time I've thought, yes, we can actually beat brain cancer. Brain tumors come in different types. So the one we hear the most about is glioblastoma, like Senator John McCain and Senator Teddy Kennedy. And the reason those are so serious is that they infiltrate the brain tissue.
Glioblastoma can grow in multiple ways and can have resistance to therapy. Our current standard of care is surgery and then radiation given with chemotherapy.
In my view, the research and treatment for glioblastoma, the real cutting edge breakthroughs are going to be coming through use of the immune system. And I think that's an area we're intensely exploring. And most importantly for us, use of T-cell therapy, which is identifying targets, but engineering patients' T-cells to be able to attack tumor cells. Our work has led to a lot of excitement, both at Penn and across the country.
Penn is the leader in immunotherapy, not just in the state, but on a national basis. The whole T-cell trials that originated at the University of Pennsylvania have made a huge difference, and we are the first center in the United States to use T-cells for glioblastoma.
This is such an important time to be in this space.
This is the real inflection point for our ability to make an impact.
There are individuals who are long-term survivors of glioblastoma. And by survival, I mean 10 years, 20 years. There's only one way that can happen, and that's the body's immune system recognizing the intruder, the cancer cell. So now that we can harness the body's immune system and regulate it to attack these tumor cells, I think we've got a shot.